home because there are different people who will be singing, telling rhymes. And in the same way, if we teach English in the classroom, the process of acquisition will be faster. Then another important thing at home, which is not possible in the classroom. At home, there will be one or two children who are learning. But in your classroom, you have 30, 40 children. That makes your job difficult. So paying personal attention to children is important. What is the meaning of few learners or single learner is, the more personal attention we can give to the children, the more it is possible that they will acquire language. This is very, very important. The last two points, no or low expectation. Don't put pressure. Now, Vagdishwara sir said something nice. You encourage them to speak, but don't put pressure on them to speak, because when you put pressure on them, then they become uncomfortable. They will keep quiet and they will not speak. So teacher should encourage them to speak English, but not create fear in their minds. And also what Krashna hypothesis says is, there is always a long period of silence. So if you see initially, not to be afraid that the child is not speaking the language immediately, because like the home language also, we know that the child is listening to the language the whole first year of birth. The child doesn't start speaking after birth. The child will start speaking towards the end of the first year, after his 9th month or 10th month. So that much the child has to listen. So even English, you keep on talking. Don't expect the child to immediately respond in English, but encourage the children, and over a period of time, they will themselves start speaking to you in English. That is what is the meaning of long period of silence. So these are all the principles connected to something called acquisition. In acquisition, the process is very subconscious. Okay. So can somebody read out what's in the note window if it's visible? Can one of you who's not spoken so far read what is in the note window? Is it visible?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Yeah. Whoever is reading can go ahead. Please go ahead.
Yeah. According to,
there are two independent systems of second language performance. The acquired system and the learned system. The acquired system or acquisition is the product of a subconscious process very similar to the process children undergo when they acquire their first language. It requires meaningful interaction in the target language. Natural communication in which speakers are concentrated not in the form of their utterances but in the communicative act. Should I continue, sir?
Good. Yes, sir. Continue. Complete the whole.
Yeah. Language acquisition occurs subconsciously while participating in natural conversations or communications where the focus is listening. The learning of a language occurs separately where grammar, vocabulary and other rules about the target language are explicitly taught. There is a focus on analyzing errors and correcting them. The focus in the aspect of learning is not on the content or meaning of the conversation or book, but rather on the structure of the language. The learned system or learning is the product of formal instruction, and it comprises a conscious process which results in conscious knowledge about the language. For example, knowledge of grammar rules according to Prussian processes are important first, and learning should follow acquisition.
Thank you very much, sir. Yeah, thank you. Let me explain this. Here in this text, we are talking about acquisition and learning both. So acquisition is the process by which the child acquires the first language. Acquisition is a subconscious process. It's a natural process. It occurs when we are talking to the children in normal conversation. So if an English teacher goes to the classroom and says, "Hey Ramesh, can you get me a glass of water? Hey Sushila, can you go outside and see if so-and-so teacher is present in the school?" So that is a conversation which has a purpose, which has a meaning, and the child has to understand it and act on it. So that is a process of normal conversation, natural conversation, where the purpose is to communicate meaning. That is called acquisition. That is where first language or home language is learned. And Krashen says the English teacher should try to bring in acquisition methods and processes in English teaching in the classroom, where English is used primarily for communicating meaning, and that will help the language acquisition happen. In the learning process is the different process. In learning, we are focusing on the structure of language. If there is a child is making a mistake, we are correcting the mistake. We are saying, no, this is singular, this is plural, this is active voice, you should speak in passive voice. There, the focus on the language or the grammar is high in the process of learning. So Krashen is saying very clearly that acquisition has to happen first and then only learning should be focused on. Now, the challenge that high school teachers have got, you're all high school teachers, is you'll have this challenge that the children should have learned English basics in the primary school. By the time they come to high school, there is a lot of focus on grammar, there is a focus on composition, there is a focus on formally understanding English language. And that is a challenge that is already there. And the syllabus is going to focus a lot on the structure of language also, where the opportunities for meaning making will be very less. But that is a challenge and dilemma for the high school teacher. My own suggestion, my own opinion is that if there are children in your classroom who are already comfortable with English, they can already understand English, they can already speak English, for them focusing on syllabus level content makes sense. However, if in your classroom there are children who are not at all comfortable with English, for them it is still very alien, they are not able to understand basic words. Alphabet is different. Alphabet is still structure of the language, but even basic simple words they are not able to understand. In their case, the acquisition process is very important. And if the teacher is simply going to focus on the syllabus or on the process of learning, those children will never learn English. They must the exam, they may fail the exam, but they will not have learnt English. And to that extent, the teacher would have failed in helping them become comfortable with English. So this is the first principle of acquisition or learning. The process of learning also, I just highlighted the points now. If you see, it's contrasting with that of acquisition. In learning, there is a lot of focus on structure of the language. There is a conscious and continuous practice of the language. And in our school, unfortunately, we focus a lot of time on the structure of the language because the syllabus encourages us to focus on the language, particularly the high school syllabus. But the problem with learning is it fails to build communicative competencies in the language if the acquisition process are adequately emphasized. Okay. Now I want us to, do we agree with this? I'm going to again share it on the normal mode. I spoke about it. Anybody agrees, disagrees with what is being spoken now? That Krashen very clearly says that between acquisition and hypothesis, better to focus on acquisition in the beginning and then you can go to learning. Whereas in high school, unfortunately, lot of our focus tends to be on the structure of language rather than the communicative processes of language. So Shekhar sir is saying school should create a friendly environment to communicate. So that communicating in English with meaning will be much more important than the structure of the language itself. Is that okay? Is that correct? Do people agree?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes. Yes. Arjunan sir, you are saying that teaching maths and science in English medium is wrong. It is better to teach all subjects in mother tongue medium only, you are saying. But is that true for all levels, or it may be true only for the initial levels? Because let's say the child has learned English very comfortably in the primary level. Then in the secondary education, that is high school, if the child is learning maths or science in English, would that be wrong, Arjunan sir?
No, sir. In the beginning stage, it is the mother tongue only, sir.
Yeah. I agree. I think everybody agrees, all the education people completely agree that, for example, in Andhra Pradesh, I don't know how teachers are, what is their opinion, but personally, I feel it is a very wrong idea to make all the primary schools from class one in English medium, sir. Because the students are not ready for that. And finally, teacher will also suffer, but student will suffer more because that foundation, what Arjunan sir is telling, that foundation is not taken care of. But another point I'm making is, supposing foundation is good, supposing in the primary level the English has been taught well, the child has learnt English well, then maybe in high school, even in higher primary, higher secondary school, if maths and science is learnt in English, I would say that is not wrong. That choice may be given. But primary, I am fully agreeing with Arjun and sir. Yes, Srileta madam, you want to say something? Srileta madam, then Shekhar sir.
Yes, sir. I completely agree with you, sir. I am the teacher from AP. My feeling also is like same, sir. My teachers, my colleague teachers, some are facing so many difficulties. They are implementing English medium at a time. And so many teachers, especially in the primary teacher, they are not comfortable with the teaching, sir. When the teacher is herself facing some problem, how can she guide the children?
Yeah, I agree. It is a very difficult thing. Yeah. Even if the teachers may be competent, what happens in primary level, it takes a lot of time to learn English. It is not going to, because it is not a language spoken at home. The parents are not going to support the English because they don't know English. So English can be learned over a long period of time. So Arjun sir, I agree with you. So primary level English medium is a very dangerous approach. And I think teachers groups, teachers unions in Andhra Pradesh should certainly raise the issue. Unlike Telangana, it is not like that. Karnataka or Kerala, everywhere, government is not forcing English in the primary. Of course, private schools are doing, but some of the private schools, well-to-do children, elite children go, they may be getting more support in home. But government school is not like that. Yes, Shekhar sir, go ahead. And then Anuradha madam. Yes, Shekhar sir.
Sir, good afternoon, sir. I am from Telangana, sir.
Yes, sir. Where in Telangana?
Sir, Telangana, Ellareddpet mandal, sir.
Which old mandal? Which district, sir?
Rajanna Sirsilla, sir.
Okay, I understand. It is near Hyderabad only, right? Not very far away. It's a new district.
Sir, here in my school, the live example is only the language teachers are using spoken in the classroom. At the same time, the school environment. But our subject teachers are not. At least minimum they are talking English. They communicate in English. The children are communicate. At the same time, they motivate. But the subject teachers are not using, at least in the classroom. So that is why we are decreasing our communicate system in our school environment.
It's a challenge. But you are using English in your classroom, sir? Are you using English in your own classroom?
Yes, sir. We are using, but outside we are not using.
Yes.
Not supporting our staff.
That is true.
If they are using, we are very much encouraged to us.
Yeah, that is true. So more that is what the first point is, that significant talking to. If you see in that Krashen's hypothesis, I'm highlighting the point. Significant talking to. More the child listens to English. It may be, ideally if it is in other periods, it will be better. But you can even encourage, you know, sometimes there is All India Radio, news will be there in English. So even if they listen to the news regularly over a period of time, more and more they listen, the better for them. Yes, Anuradha madam, go ahead.
Thank you, sir. Sir, as per Prashin's hypothesis, acquisition of language is possible by listening and observing in the environment, no, sir? What I want to tell you is the same thing that they have reported before. So that the environment is lacking in our schools, no, sir. Because if it is a mother tongue, first language, everybody corrects. If a child is speaking, mother, father, and brother, everybody there, whoever is available there, they'll keep correcting, sir. But such environment is not available here, no, sir, because all teachers are. There the problem arises. Only in English class, they are exposed to language.
Yeah, sir. That is true. So I'll just respond to Anuradha madam and then Ravindra Babu. Anuradha madam, so see, one important thing is, some things are under our control, meaning our own classroom, our own classes under our control. And therefore, let's say as an English teacher, if I speak a lot of English in my classroom, if I give some assignment by which children are able to listen to English at home, then
to the extent, the same thing, sir.
Yeah, very good, madam. But some things are not in our control. For example, we can request the mathematics teacher to speak in English in the classroom, but if the teacher doesn't speak, it is not under our control. So we can only interpret crash hypothesis from the point of view, what are the things we can do? But you are very right. I agree with you. If only one teacher is speaking English, it will take more time.
Because of my effort, what I have done all these years. So 80% of my classroom is filled with English language only, sir. Whenever necessary, nice, I use Telugu language, sir.
Yes, only for bridging.
They have reached a level where they are able to understand, not speak, sir. They are able to understand what I'm teaching, sir.
Yes. First step, Anuradha madam, first step is understanding only. That's why when we say LRS, LSRW, first year we have to focus, and that's what Krishna also tells, long silence will be there. We should not be uncomfortable. Children, if you put pressure on them to start speaking, that courage, they will start getting afraid of the teacher. So if you talk to them a lot, slowly, if they understand, first process of language is only understanding. Like I have come a lot to Telangana and Andhra. Now, little when I listen to Telugu, I can understand Telugu. I cannot speak Telugu because I am not feeling the confidence. For me, Telugu is a second language. But at least because I listen to so much Telugu, if somebody is talking in Telugu to people, I will be able to understand and follow what they are doing. Yes, that is very important. Yeah. So let's go ahead. We will try to look at the acquisition hypothesis is connected to the input hypothesis, which says that lot of emphasis has to be given on the it is called caretaker language. If you see what word Krishna is using, caretaker language means a person who's with the child as a caretaker. That person, how he talks to the child, that same way teacher has to talk to the child. So caretaker language means, again, what we told earlier, that focus is on meaning making. So whenever the caretakers are talking to the children, caretaker can be mother, father, uncle, relative, elder brother, elder sister. So the caretaker, when they talk to the children, they're always focusing on the children's understanding. And what Anandala madam was telling just now, if the children are able to understand what we are speaking, that is the important element of the caretaker language. But what is Krishna says is not at all a good approach to do. There are two things which are having cross, if you can see there. One thing cross is saying mechanical drill is not a good approach. So we may be making the children to repeat something several times. They may be making the children to write down something several times. That mechanical drill is not a meaningful activity, and that will not help the process of acquisition. So input should be meaningful, input should be understandable, input should be like a caretaker. And Krishna also says give lot of opportunities for peer learning. So even in your classroom, there will be some children who are comfortable speaking English, some are not comfortable. That peer learning becomes very useful in the classroom. So that is very important. Swarnalatha madam has raised a very important point. She says that exams are conducted according to the syllabus, then how shall we manage? So Swarnalatha's question, madam's question is very, very important. I don't have an answer to that simply because it is a dilemma for the teacher. Syllabus, if I go according to the syllabus, then the child may be able to write the exam. But if I go according to the syllabus and children are not ready for the syllabus, children are not going to learn. So my suggestion to Swarnalatha madam, and this is my opinion, and I believe in it very strongly, is that finally children should get the benefit of the class. Children should get the benefit of the learning process. If the children are at the syllabus level and you teach at the syllabus level, they will understand. But if the children are not at the syllabus level, then if you do not teach them at the level that they are in, they are not going to learn anything. They may by heart something, they may write the exam. Particularly for English, we always see that children may read the word, but they don't know the meaning of the word. They may write the, you can make them by heart a paragraph and write that paragraph in the exam. They may get the marks and they may pass. But to my mind, that is not a good way of teaching because the syllabus is completed, but the child has not learned. I have a phrase for it. You know, I call it operation successful, patient dead. I call it operation successful, patient dead. So the syllabus is the focus of the teacher and the children are not learning. In my opinion, teacher should be having the freedom to teach as per the... So Anuradha madam has said something in the chat window, which I fully agree. And I wish and I pray that teacher should be given the freedom, because more we put pressure on the teacher to complete the syllabus, more the children are not going to learn, because the teacher will feel pressurized to teach exactly as per the textbook. What somebody told textbook and subtext in the beginning of the session, it is important that we have to be able to give them the flexibility and freedom to teach as per the level of the children. So Shekhar sir has asked meaning making. Meaning making means whatever I tell the children, they should be understanding it. That is what is called meaning making. So if I am telling Shekhar sir, I am I did my schooling in Bombay. You understand the meaning of that. So that process by which you are understanding the meaning of a communication, that is called a meaningful conversation. But when something is not understandable by the child, so if you are reading a poem to the child and the child is not at all understanding that meaning of that, then the child is unable to make the meaning. So meaning making means something that the child finds meaningful, something the child is able to understand, and that is called the process of meaning making. Our problem with the syllabus is that many times the syllabus will have some textbook or some chapter, prose or poetry, which we know clearly well. If I read this out to the children, these 10 children will not understand at all because it is at a different level from where they are. So then meaning making is not happening. Shekhar sir, I hope you understood the meaning of the phrase meaning making. The child should be able to make meaning of what is happening in the classroom. Okay, so it's 3-3 now. I think we have to take a break at this point in time. 3 to 3:10 was supposed to be the break. So can we take a break from now till 3:10 and come back?
Yes, sir.
So I will be there here only, but we can take a short break and reassemble at 3:10. You can continue to be logged in. You don't need to log out. But we can just between now and 3:10, just for 6 minutes, we can take a short break. If you have any questions, please type in the chat window and I'll respond to it after 3:10.